My name is Steve Robertson, and I'm the author of The Power of Choice, Success, and Your Life Purpose. In the last video, we discussed how and why your thoughts and spoken words co-create. And as a quick recap, we discussed several key points from the Bible as a spiritual reference point. In the beginning was the Word was with God, God said, let there be light, and that the Word in the Bible actually means primary harmony, and the Word was made flesh and full of grace and dwelt among us, which is why Einstein states, energy and mass are different forms of the same thing. Now, we added to this, King Solomon said in the Bible, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Again, the word man is a Sanskrit word which means consciousness. So if we look in Genesis, it says man was created in the image of God. We can only assume from the definitional context of this is that our consciousness is created in the likeness of God's consciousness. Many of us are aware or have discussed that we have transitioned from the end of the Mayan calendar into a new era. I believe this transitional state represents moving consciousness, the collective consciousness, from the persona, which in Latin means to pump air through your mask, let's say the mask of the ego, into becoming this new era of becoming the heretic, which in Latin means the person who knows that they can choose. Now, to granulate a little bit further on how and why our words co-create, let's look at the basics of word structure. Every word, as we know, is made of a letter, and that letter is either a consonant or a vowel sound. And so each and every time we say a word, that consonant or that vowel sound has a very specific frequency to it, a very specific vibration, if you will. So in essence, every time we say any word, it is analogous to hitting several keys on the piano simultaneously. We are sending out an aggregate frequency of causation. Now, the relevance of this with regards to our intent is scientifically proven through what's called the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. In the late 1800s, the English physicist Thomas Young did an experiment called the double slit experiment. I'll show a diagram of this in just a moment. This basically concluded his null hypothesis was that light traveled in a wave-like pattern, and he proved this through what was called the double slit experiment. About 100 years later, Einstein came around and said, that is not correct. Light travels as though it's being shot out of a gun, in what was called the photoelectric principle. So this was confounding to the physics community in that light was proven to travel in a wave-like form and as well being shot out of a gun. Now, the German physicist came along, Heisenberg, came along and said, guess what? It's both. And it travels as either a wave or as a being shot out of a gun because our thought at a subatomic level causes that outcome. This is a significant distinction within the context of how our thoughts and our spoken words co-create. Because again, in recapping what we discussed in the last video we did, is that when we think, this is a certain frequency of causation. And when we speak, we are amplifying the field of causation. In other words, we are accelerating mass into form. People, situations, circumstances, etc. So it is vitally important that as human beings, as we both think and speak and co-create, that we are doing so in a very conscious way. If we find that the history of our life has brought a vernacular of, let's say, unpleasant, unkind, and curse words, and that becomes a staple by which we are articulating our life, be clear that the only level of causation that you're going to be creating is a lot of drama, stress, and negativity. This is just the reality. Again, you can't plant a turnip seed and get a fruit tree. This is the reality of how things work. If we align our thoughts from an empowered present moment state, proclaiming who we are as co-creators and claiming that we are going to co-create from, if you will, the hero's journey. In the hero's journey, the hero leaves the village of conformity. They're pursuing the grail. They are pursuing the slaying the dragon, whatever that particular hero's journey is. They are tested many, many, many times along the way until they come upon the grand test. And this is the bridge of no return. The true hero crosses the bridge of no return, and then they turn to the bridge and they burn it down. And therefore, the only way that they can focus their attention is on the goal, not where they were, not the village, and not the journey and each test they went along the way, but the goal. And that is a key distinction that is important to bring into the presence of how you think and how you speak and how you act. And that is to co-create, to choose to create from the hero's perspective. And that is to co-create from what you really do want, as opposed to what you don't want. And again, this is a key distinction from the book, The Power of Choice, Success in Your Life Purpose. I hope this has been helpful. And if you wish to reach out to me, if there's any way that I can help or support or serve you, it would be my honor.